This is a simple experiment to show you about eddy currents. What is here? This is a copper tunnel which is hollow inside. I have two objects with me. One is magnet. This is spherical magnet. This is normal copper cube which has no magnet property. I will show you first when I put this cube at the top. You will find it comes out at other end quickly. It is because of the gravity. I am leaving it now. See, I left and it comes out immediately. Check it again. I leave it and it will come down immediately under gravity. Now I am putting a spherical magnet at this end. When this magnet moves through a copper tunnel, eddy currents are generated on the surface of the metallic tunnel, so the motion of this spherical magnet is restricted. You see, it takes too much time, even in rod nickel, to come out at the other end. I have dropped it. It has not come out yet. See, it has not come out yet. It has not come out yet. Now, yeah, now it has come out. Let me explain why does it happen when I put right from the top a normal copper cube. It comes down immediately because it accelerates because of the gravity. Secondly, I put a spherical magnet, and you have seen an experiment. It takes too much time to come at another end. However, the copper rod is still vertical, so expectedly your spherical magnet should also move with the gravity. But it is taking too much time to come out at other end. It means acceleration of spherical magnet is lesser than the gravity. How come this acceleration becomes less than the gravity? It is because when magnet moves through this copper tube, it generates eddy currents on the surface of this entire surface of the tube. And according to Lenz's law, the induced EMF opposes the motion of an object, so it opposes the motion of a spherical magnet. That's why its acceleration is less than g.